You're so cute. What you doing? Are you ready for me to clean your tank? You want some new toys? Yeah, you want some new toys? I know that bottle completely doesn't match, does it? Hey guys, it's Hopping Hammy, and today's video I'm going to be showing you how I changed Carob's Valentine's cage theme to her recent springtime theme. Now, a lot of people ask me how often that I clean this cage, and I don't have a specific time frame that I do it since it depends on how tidy that the hamster is and how quickly that they dirty it. In this particular cage, I was using two dishes in each corner as her potty area, and for the most part, she did pee in these spots as well as on her wheel, so that cuts down quite a bit on the cage itself getting dirty. Now, as a quick note, it is typically best to save some of the old bedding to sprinkle over the new, especially if your hamster is easily stressed out. Carob is a very well-adjusted hamster and she loves exploring new areas, so for that particular reason, I am not saving any of her bedding this time. So I'm going to go ahead and get started on this video. You'll get to see a time lapse of me changing out the bedding, changing the background, and just explaining a little bit about the process that I go through to change cage themes. So I hope you enjoy watching this. So once I vacuum the bedding and the sand out of the cage, typically I will wipe it down in areas that it needs to be wiped down. Now, like I said, because she does pee in her sand pit mostly, it keeps the rest of the cage very clean, so I don't actually have to do that this time. So normally what I will do for the next step is I will put up the wrapping paper as a backdrop once I figure out what I want to do. But I haven't actually decided on like what color theme I'm gonna do, so I'm gonna actually dump the aspen bedding in first, and that way I can get a sense of how it looks. And then I'm gonna just sort of push it aside and put the wallpaper in the back behind it. So we'll go ahead and dump the bedding in now. So I am using aspen bedding, and this is the Harlan Techlad brand. And this is a big bag that I bought online from pet360.com. They were having a wonderful sale when I bought it, so I stocked up and I got like four bags. I do like how finely shredded that this bedding is, but my only complaint is the fact that it is pretty dusty, so I'm probably going to be sneezing quite a lot after this. Okay, so there is literally dust floating everywhere in my room right now. It's all landing on my camera and everything, so I'm gonna let the dust settle a bit and try to figure out which wrapping paper that I want to put up in the background. The first one is this green color, which has some shiny green polka dots. I have to say, I don't think this really screams spring right now. It definitely screams more like St. Patrick's Day or like a green theme. The second one that I have is this punchy polka dotted one, which you guys know how I feel about punchy. I love punchy. Now that I see it with the brown bedding though, I have to say I don't really think it adds enough pizzazz. It's just kind of a little bit bland. So the third option that I have is this colorful chevron print. I'm just gonna hold it like this even though the stripes are going the wrong way. I definitely think that it looks like it could be spring and it adds enough color to the tank. I can use the colors for inspiration on things to put in here to match. So I think I'm definitely going to be going with this one today. So I'm going to save the dry sand from her dish, but I'm just going to sift out the pieces of bedding and poop that are mixed in, so that way I can use the dry sand and not waste it. So I came up with the idea that I wanted to do something that looked like grass. So I have these pieces of paper here, and I'm just going to stack them together and then cut some strips so that it looks like grass. So I'm just going to go like this and basically just make some slits like this. So now comes the fun part of actually setting up the cage. And okay, I will admit that I cheated slightly and I set the entire cage up first before filming because I had no idea where anything was going. So it took me at least an hour or so to figure all of that out beforehand, but at least I'm being honest. Normally it takes much longer than what you see here. So most of the time I have no idea how the layout will end up, and I tend to change things around quite a bit because I normally start with either the largest items or the items that I know pretty much where I want to put them, and then I will just work around those and figure out how much space is left and move things as needed. At the very end is usually when I will add the tiny details such as the wood chews, the oat sprays, and all of the little decor items that really just pull the theme together. So this is pretty much how it turned out, and I did adjust it a little bit. So then of course, after I did that the first time, I decided that I wanted to use a paper puncher to punch out some yellow dots and just sprinkle those over the bedding. I thought it would look like dandelions, and it turned out really cool looking. I actually quite like it, so that's a fun idea. Now this colored paper that I used for the dandelions and the grass is something that I've used in past cage themes, and I've never had a problem with it. Now, I'm not saying that every single paper out there is safe, but generally I tend to think it isn't an issue unless your hamster pouches bedding to take back to their nest. So Carob enjoys pouching her food, but she does not pouch her bedding, and I've never seen her do this since I've adopted her, so I'm not worried about it. And don't forget also, if you are hesitant to use colored paper, you can always just use colored bedding that is sold specifically for pets, such as the Eco Bedding Crinkles or some other type of paper-based bedding such as KT Clean and Cozy or Carefresh. So I think I basically covered everything as far as showing you how I put together a cage theme. Now I do have another type of video on the subject as well. It has a slightly different slant to it, but you might also find that enjoyable to watch, so I'll put that down in the description bar below. Thank you so much for watching this, and I hope you have a great weekend. Bye!